Yo, I know I'm not the only one super excited for this game, so I've gathered all the latest and greatest gameplay footage I could find on the web. So let's analyze these clips we've been gifted and try to get ahead of other players, whether you decide to be a family member main or victim main. Me personally, I would be a... you're gonna find out. But again, early access starts this month, so if you haven't wishlisted the game on Steam, be sure to do that. The official game comes out August 18th. Alright, here we go. So here we have Leatherface chasing Julie outside the gas station. And if you wonder how I know that, other than being a genius, JK JK, there's a lit sign to the right of the screen. I mean, I'm probably sure it says open or close. I'm not completely sure where this is on the gas station, but it looks like she's about to escape until she wasn't, on the side next to the two vehicles. And looking at this map, there's an arrow which probably means that's the way to escape, so she wasn't too far, I guess. Then we see my boy Leland stunning the hitchhiker on what looks like the slaughterhouse map. I ain't gonna stay too much on that. Then we got Anna powering up the exit on what again looks like the slaughterhouse map. And then here we got Connie rummaging through bones, and I'm thinking we find ready-made weapons to aid in our escape and stuns. You'll see why in future clips. Just stay with me. Now we got my boy Sonny struggling to get this lock open. If you checked out my victims video, you know Connie would come in clutch right here. Another searching for items clip, and I'm not exactly sure where Leland is, but I know he don't want to be there. You see that leg? So throughout the family house map, there will be chickens that will aid in alerting the family where you are. I'm not sure if silencing them consumes your weapon, but my guess is it does. So you gotta decide to let that chick cluck or shut that bitch up. Now for some actual gameplay. Keep in mind, we all start in the basement with Leatherface on the family house. Don't be too scared, this basement's big AF, it's not like DBD, bro. Remember, when I said we can have weapons, in the bottom right above your health state, you can see we can carry up to two items, whether that's a medkit or a weapon. I'm not sure what else we can carry just yet. Below our items, we have our stamina bar with 5 notches. And below that, we have our health bar in green to show we feeling real good, for now. Underneath that display is our ultimate escape ability. As you move throughout each map, pay attention to the little circles that pop up that indicate possible actions. Like there's that lamp that's an action to turn on the light, and then there's a bottle which I feel like may aid in health. I'm hella excited to experience getting away from the killer through crawl spaces and not always having to vault something. I love that we're gonna have the ability to lock and unlock doors, because it's gonna be hella useful to buy time, whether we trying to hide some more or get distance. Me, I'm trying to get some distance. I'm not about to sit in here and wait for you. It's two other killers I gotta worry about. So the little circles are showing we can either squeeze through the crack in the wall, hide in the freezer, or squeeze past some junk. But my man Sonny needs to go get him an item. But at least he's fully healed and he can still use his hide sense ability. Whenever a family member is alerted by noise, the area lights up in red, telling us where to go. Killers have the capability to barge through locked doors, and victims can burst out of hiding spaces. Not sure if it'll stun the family members just yet, but if you're a hitchhiker or a sissy, you can crawl through spaces to sneak around, tricking the victim to thinking you left. It also looked like family members can search for items as well. Maybe this is to aid Hitchhiker with his traps. For the family members in the bottom right, we have 3 diamonds next to the grandpa, and I'm guessing that's the amount of packs of blood we can carry if we want to gather as much as we can before feeding him. When you feed Gramps blood, he can tell us where every victim is instantly. Underneath that, we have our 3 slots showing we have 3 traps ready to set, and the amount of blood we've collected so far, which is 0 at the moment. Underneath that, it looks like our ability drain is tracker. This one, I'm not 100% on, but I'm just using context clues for real. Always feel free to correct your boy if I'm wrong. I don't know everything, so I won't take offense. We have a few ways out the basement, but only 2 ways to escape the map and win. Connie should have searched that box because she doesn't have an item, just her focus ability ready to use. But depending on how long it takes to search, she probably would have got caught. I wonder what made him check that freezer for real. She must have jumped in that bed and made a loud noise. Ooh, we see some health on the table. See, I'ma need to wait before I search for items because I would have been dead 2 times. It's a search, I'ma search. Search and die. We see the cook hasn't gathered any blood, but he still has 3 of his locks ready to use at any time, along with his seek ability. Hey, peep the medical supplies on the left. My boy Sonny finally has two items that look like weapons, and although he can use them to cut the bones down or to silence a chicken or two, we might need both since we're not fully healed, just in case we get caught up. This may be common sense, but keep in mind, when you jump out of windows, especially from the second floor, you will take hella damage. So if you ain't got that much help, don't do that backflip out the window. You will die. Here we have Sissy, and in the bottom right displayed is her ability Bane with 3 full slots, and if you noticed, on the other 3 family members, the max blood they could carry was 100, but Sissy's max is 120. Johnny doesn't have any ability slots displayed, and he carries the least amount of blood, which is 85. But I wonder if that has to do with him just enjoying the thrill of the cube. So setting traps up will take some time, which gives victims distance and time to search. But if a victim steps in that trap, that will also take time to escape, giving the family members a chance to ambush you. Although we can't kill the family members, Leland can use his ability to stun, but here he uses his weapon instead of a lifesaver ability. I'm thinking the weapon provides a longer stun, giving victims more distance, or he was just saving it when he got closer to the exit just in case he needed to use it. Leatherface doesn't have any ability slots displayed either, but we can see that he's fed Gramps at least once, and it appears he's used his chainsaw some since it's only half full. Leatherface can either unlatch a door or simply destroy it. It doesn't appear to have any effect on his chainsaw usage at the moment, so he's about to be cutting through everything he can't fit through for real. Any Leatherface mains watching this video? Comment and let me know. And here's what happens when you feed Granddaddy the blood. And if you pause the video, you'll notice to the right of the chainsaw commands, we don't only have to collect blood from executions, you can collect it off the floor. Another item that can be carried that victims would really want is the fuse to restore the power to the basement door. I'm not sure where the fuse will be, but the place to put it is upstairs on the third floor in the luggage room. Hey, good luck and have fun finding that bad boy.
Is always forever, 'cause one is one is one. Look inside yourself or your father. All is one, all is none, none is one.